Hi boys and girls, it's Mike here, one go short play, taking up the challenge from Martin at the Dusty Joypad. This is a bit of a... We're going back a bit with this challenge. It's a post-mortem of a challenge. A couple of weeks ago, maybe a week or so ago, Martin played Shadow of the Beast 2. It was another YouTuber that played it first, and he's taken up the challenge. I'm going to check out that other YouTuber because I love checking out new YouTubers. I found a few new YouTubers lately and made up, and you guys seem to be talking to each other and doing stuff together. Now, I don't have much time to do that, but I do want to try. So, and I'm always trying to do that whenever I get time. I've got a 21-month-old and full-time work, and I'm trying to make a game as well. So, life's a bit full on. I got up at 5:30 this morning so I could do this. It's a little bit past that now. But I really wanted to play Shadow of the Beast 2 because you guys played it, and I used to love this game. When I first got my Amiga, I had two mates who lived near me with Amigas, Dan and Luke, and Luke had this game for his Amiga, Shadow of the Beast 2. Now, this is my twist on your challenge. I'm playing the Amiga version because I think this was the original version, and as you can see, it's already got something that the Mega Drive version didn't have, which is an intro sequence, a really, really good intro sequence that when I was, 13? I think it was 13, it absolutely blew my mind. I had a Spectrum, and don't get me wrong, that was an amazing machine for its time, but this was absolutely magical to me, and it just compounded my need for an Amiga, and I had one a year later for Christmas. I badgered my mum enough, and I loved it. And I got totally into deluxe paint and went into games art after that. Totally down to my love of this machine and games and computers in general. Anyway, that aside, this is the Amiga version of Shadow of the Beast 2. As you can see, the first thing you'll notice is it's got an intro that kind of gives you backstory. And it's a really good backstory. It's dark and a bit spooky. And as you can see now, this used to scare me. There it comes. Look at that. But how beautifully done is this? I mean, this is some dark stuff, boys and girls. And this just made me want more. I wanted an Amiga. anyway, this is Shadow of the Beast 2 on the Amiga. Now, I'm not good at it. I've never played it without cheating, I don't think. But there's a cheat on the Amiga that lets you see a bit more. And I'm going to do that while I talk about it. But first of all, I'm going to have a go at the challenge. I'm going to see how far I can get. No, I won't get any further than anyone else has got. I'm telling you that now. I had a little go at this morning when I got up, just to see if I could, and I just got owned by it. Pardon me while I just change discs. Okay. So the disadvantage with the Amiga versions of these games is the waiting time while you're loading. There's waiting time while it decompacts bits of levels, so if you hit a certain point within a level, it will load the next bit. You know, it does stuff like that, but the advantage with the Amiga is this sort of thing. That's right, boys and girls. The original Tim Wright music, as it is meant to sound. The Amiga worked with samples, broadly speaking, rather than chip tunes. So the original versions of these songs are absolutely gorgeous, as you can hear. Now, Tim Wright is better known as Cold Storage, and you'll probably know him from Wipeout. He performed the music from those games. Excuse me, I think I've got my pad set up a bit wrong. Oh no, it's alright. It was just taking its time. So, the second thing you'll notice is the sprite on the Amiga is different. He's not as big, and he's also not as well drawn, but that's okay, because as you'll notice from the Mega Drive version, the enemy sprites aren't that well drawn either, so they matched. Now, well, they matched on the Amiga version, but on the Mega Drive, of course, the player sprite looks better than everything else, which I suppose it should. It's the player sprite is on the screen 100% of the time, but it always jarred a little bit with me. Here's the loading time. We're currently loading. Yeah, everything pauses, but it doesn't matter because we've got this awesome music going on. I hate this bit. Just like lost half a life doing that. This game was never fair. That was kind of its main thing. I remember correctly. Yes, yes. Now, when I played this morning, that killed me. Yeah, I know how. It killed me because taking to rescue. I'm sure Master, you have to be careful not to press fire, because otherwise you do that and kill him. Reward you, Barloom, eh? Barloom, is it? Right, basically he's saying, off you go. This is probably where I die on this challenge, but I'm going to try. You don't waste time trying to kill stuff, you just get out of its way. Oh no! That's not what I want to do. Now, the reason that bit killed me before was because up is jump on the Amiga. Oh no, oh, we didn't even want to do that. There you go, I'm dead. Okay, that was my challenge over. I think you're supposed to go right when you get to the bottom. The game is not easy. The game is not fair. It's, I think it's a design flaw. You can't really get far in this game without cheating. Now, but it's worth it for this. Guitar badly. Yeah, it's got samples, so that's how that's supposed to sound. How cool was that? Yeah, that's an awesome game over screen, isn't it? I'm gonna cheat now. We're gonna see a bit more. You're not gonna see everything. I'm just gonna show you a little bit more of the game. This is how I knew Shadow of the Beast on the Amiga. Shadow of the Beast 2 on the Amiga. Now, I don't think this is as good as the original game. And I can't remember the guy, was it Martin Edmonds? I can't remember the name of the guy who did the music for the original game. But I thought it was better. The sequel evokes the music, the kind of audio style of the first game pretty well. But the first game had melodies that this one doesn't. Now, I first played the original Shadow of the Beast after seeing this. But I played Shadow of the Beast on the Spectrum. Let's cheat. We go right. You can't do this on the Mega Drive. Ah, no, don't hit me. Right, stand there. No one passes, I would. I think it's S. No, it's not S. T for tour. There's a key here somewhere. I'll find it. I'm just pressing away along the keyboard. You don't accept bribes. I don't want to bribe you. Ah, ask about what? It's A for ask. And we go 10 pints. I'm guessing that's Roger Dean, the guy who did the cover art. If you watch Martin's video, he tells you a bit about that. Basically, yeah, part of Reflections trying to get Psygnosis to sign up the original Shadow of the Beast was they got the artist who did the Yes covers to do the cover art. Okay, as you can see, I am now invincible, which is good because, let's face it, no one gets through these woods alive. I'm just gonna run so you can see stuff. I might die somewhere, I might make a stupid mistake. This game is flawed to the point where you can make stupid mistakes and die. Or get stuck, you know, and that's the last thing you want. There's a lot of flaws in these games. They are, the thing is though, they are absolutely gorgeous. I wish there was a jump button though. Later Amiga games did let you jump with a jump button. Lionheart and looking at you, that was awesome. Look at how cool those baddies are. But you see the way this guy's a bit more in style with them. I know he's not very detailed compared with them. And you can totally see why they redrew him. But I think, I like that monster being loads bigger than him. And I didn't like that they made him bigger. I don't know why I killed that. Oh yeah, that's why. It wasn't ready. I just killed it. I preferred the first Shadow of the Beast though, because it was the original idea, stylistically and visually and audio-wise. It was the original idea. It came from nothing, you know. And this one came off the back of the original Shadow of the Beast. Which is, you know, it's going to be a better game, if they've got any sense. Nice animation though. It's going to be a better game, it should be a better game, it would be rude not to be a better game. Incidentally, this was always classed in the Amiga kind of circle as the worst Shadow of the Beast game. See, this is where you can get stuck. If you fall, I might be in trouble. If I remember rightly, you can jump out of this though. Oh no, I'm dead. That was death. Right, but you've seen that the Amiga version has cheats. Check them out. The first Shadow of the Beast is a better game, I think. The third Shadow of the Beast is the best in the series. But as I say, the only reason the first one's better is because this one rides on its coattails, if you like. But check out the third Shadow of the Beast. I don't think it ever made it to Mega Drive, but it definitely made it to Amiga, and it's different again. Similar but different. It's a really good advance. You can choose the levels that you play on, the worlds that you play first. And it's a bit easier, it's a bit more intuitive, it's a bit better designed, it's kind of got puzzle elements, it's great. Shadow of the Beast 3, it's really underrated, in my opinion. Anyway, I just thought I'd show you that on the Amiga. If you haven't seen it on the Amiga, do give it a go, check out more of it. Don't let that happen to you. And thanks very much for watching.